Good morning, students. So in previous class, I have explained you about the fourth unit introduction, right? Angle pulse modulation and what are the different types of modulations, right? Like pulse amplitude modulation, pulse width modulation and pulse position modulation, right? We have discussed about all those modulations definitions with the help of a waveforms. So in today's class, I will explain you the concept of a sampling techniques. So basically we are having three types of a sampling techniques. So the sampling of a signal can be done in several ways, but there are mainly three types of sampling techniques. So they are nothing but instantaneous sampling method, natural sampling method, flat top sampling method. So out of these three, instantaneous sampling method is known as a ideal sampling method, and natural sampling method and flat top sampling method are called as a practical sampling. So why we are calling like that, we will see in today's class. So first we will see the instantaneous sampling method. So this is the waveforms of instantaneous sampling method. So it is a simple concept. The basic phenomenon behind this instantaneous sampling method is nothing but a multiplication. So we just multiply the baseband signal with the impulse train. So in this type of sampling, the sampling function is a train of impulses. So if you observe the waveforms here, the first one is a baseband signal, which is a sinusoidal signal, and the second one is an impulse train. If you observe the second waveform impulse train, the width of the pulse must be zero. And by multiplying these two signals, we will get the output signal, that is a D. So here, figure C represents the functional diagram of a switching sampler, which will be helps to multiply the A and B. So here in the figure, we are having A and B waveforms. By multiplying these two, we will get the figure D output. So that is nothing but an instantaneous sampling. And figure D represents the sample signal. X of T is the input signal as shown in the figure 1 of A. And figure 1 of C shows the circuit to produce the instantaneous ideal sampling. This circuit is also known as a switching sampler. So that is the basic phenomenon of instantaneous sampling. It just multiplies the baseband signal and impulse train. So now if you consider the working principle, the circuit will consist of a switch. And if we assume that the closing time T of the switch approaches zero, then the output G of T of the circuit will contain only instantaneous value of the input signal X of T. Since the width of the pulse approaches zero and the instantaneous sampling gives a train of impulses of height equal to the instantaneous value of the input signal X of T at the sampling instance. So it means if you observe the circuit here, there we are having a switch, right? So whenever the switch is closed at the output side G of T, we will get the input only. And whenever the switch is open at the output side, we will get zero. I repeat again, here the input is X of T and output is G of T. In between there we are having a switch FS, right? So whenever the switch is closed, the input is, we are getting the output. So as it is, we are getting the input as a output. Whenever the switch is opened, we don't get any output. We will get zero. So that is the operation. And time of pulses may be represented by delta Ts of t is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity delta of t minus n Ts. And this is known as sampling function, and its waveforms are shown in figure 1 of B. And the sample signal G of t is expressed as the multiplication of X of t and delta Ts of t. As I said, now the output is the function of a multiplication of a baseband signal and pulses. So we will say the sample signal G of T is expressed as the multiplication of X of T and delta Ts of T. So simply we can write G of T. So G of T means output function is equal to X of T. X of T means input function into delta Ts of T. Delta Ts of T means impulses. And G of T is equal to X of T into summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity delta of T minus n Ts. And or else we can also represent it by G of T is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity X of nts into delta of T minus nts. And if we take the Fourier transform of the sample signal, we will get it as G of F is equal to Fs into summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of f minus n fs. So that is about the instantaneous sampling. Now we will see the natural sampling. So natural sampling is an practical sampling, whereas instantaneous sampling is an ideal sampling. So the basic difference in between the natural sampling and instantaneous sampling is, in instantaneous sampling the basic principle is a multiplication, whereas in natural sampling the basic principle is a multiplication and also we will use a chopping. So here the input is x of t and output is g of t. In between we are having a switch. Now we will see the operation. So the basic difference is, if you observe the waveforms here, the first one is a x of t, which is a baseband signal, and the second one is a impulses, and the third one is a output natural sampling waveform. So the main difference between the instantaneous sampling and natural sampling is, there in the instantaneous sampling the width of the pulses is zero, but here no need to be, width should be zero. Here the width have a some value, so here we are assuming it as a tau. If you observe the second waveform, there we are representing the width of the pulses as a tau. So figure 1 represents the continuous time signal, which is the input signal, and figure B represents the sampling function waveform, that is a periodic pulse train with a width of tau, and third one represents a naturally sampled signal waveform. So by multiplying and chopping the baseband signal and sampled signal, we will get the naturally sampled signal waveform. So what happened here is, so now only I said, as we have already discussed, the instantaneous sampling results in the samples whose width tau approaches zero. Due to this, the power content in the instantaneously sampled pulses is negligible. Thus, this method is not suitable for the transmission purpose. So we are using this natural sampling method. Instantaneous sampling is an ideal sampling, and this one is a practical sampling. Natural sampling is a practical method. In this type of sampling, the pulses has a finite width equal to tau. Now only I said. And let us consider an analog continuous time signal x of t to be sampled at the rate of fsh. And here we are assuming that fs is higher than the Nyquist rate, such that the sampling theorem is satisfied. And again, we are considering a sample function c of t, which is, so c of t means nothing but a periodic pulses. So that periodic pulses have a width of a tau and frequency is equal to fsh. So with the help of a natural sampler, a sample signal g of t is obtained by multiplying the sampling function c of t and input signal x of t. So the output will be obtained by multiplying the sample function c of t and input signal x of t. So now we will write it as, whenever g of t is equal to x of t, then c of t is equal to a, and g of t is equal to 0 when c of t is equal to 0, where a is the amplitude of a c of t. And now the sample signal g of t may also be described mathematically as g of t is equal to c of t into x of t. So c of t means nothing but a sampling function here, and c of t is the periodic train of a pulses whose width is a tau and frequency is a fs. And we know that the exponential Fourier series of any periodic waveform is expressed as c of t is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity c n e power j 2 pi n t by t naught. And also for the periodic pulse of train c of t, we have t naught is equal to t s is equal to 1 by fs. Why? Because we know time is equal to reciprocal of a frequency. Time and frequency are inversely proportional. So we can simply write as t s is equal to 1 by fs is equal to period of a c of t. And coming to the frequency, it can be written as f naught is equal to fs is equal to 1 by ts. And we have a c of t is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity c n into e power j 2 pi fn t, where 1 by t naught is equal to fs. Now it may be noted that since c of t is a rectangular pulse train, therefore c of cn for this waveform will be expressed as the cn is equal to t a by t naught fn t. So here t, which is a tau, and fn is a harmonic Fn is equal to n into Fs. So we can write Fs is equal to n by T naught. So 1 by T naught means, so time and frequency are inversely proportional. So 1 by T naught means we can write it as F naught. So Fs is equal to n F naught. So by replacing it, Cn is equal to tau A by Ts into sine of C into Fn into tau. And it can be written as Cn is equal to tau into A by Ts into sine of C into Fn into tau. Therefore, the Fourier series representation for C of T will be given as C of T is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity tau into A by Ts into sine of Fn into tau into e power j 2 pi Fts into nt. By substituting the value of C of T in the equation g of T, we will get, so what I have said now, g of T is the output. So we will get the output by multiplying the input and C of T. So g of T is equal to C of T into x of T. So in place of C of T, I'm substituting the value here. G of T is equal to, I'm substituting the whole C of T value. So that is tau A by Ts summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity sine of C into Fn into 2 tau into e power j 2 pi Fs nt into x of t. And this is required time domain representation for the naturally sampled signal g of t. Now to get the frequency domain representation of the naturally sampled signal, so we have to consider the Fourier transform. And the Fourier transform as a g of f is equal to Fourier transform of g of t. So by taking the Fourier transform, we will get g of f. So we will get g of f is equal to tau a by ts into summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity sine of C into Fn into tau into Fourier transform of e power g 2 pi Fs nt into x of t. So by recalling the frequency shifting property of a Fourier transform, and it states that e power j 2 pi Fs nt into x of t is equal to x of f minus fs into n. So we can be written, we can written g of f as g of f is equal to tau a by ts into summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity sine c into fn into tau into x of f minus fs n. So here fn is equal to n into fs, which is a harmonic frequency, and g of f is equal to tau a by ts summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity sine of c into nfs into tau into x of f minus nfs. So hence we will write the spectrum of a naturally sampled signal as g of f is equal to tau a by ts into summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity sine of c of nfs into tau into x of f minus nfs. So this equation shows the spectrum of x of t, that is x of f, so which is a periodic function in fs and are weighed by the sinc function. So this figure illustrates the spectrum for x of t and corresponding spectrum g of f. So first figure shows the x of t minus fm fm, and the second figure represents the spectrum of a naturally sampled signal at a function sinc of nfs minus tau. So it is the spectrum of a naturally sampled signal. So that's it for the today's class. In next class, I will explain you flat top sampling. So in today's class, we have discussed about the sampling techniques. So basically, we are having a three type sampling techniques. They are instantaneous sampling, which is ideal sampling, and also we have discussed about the natural sampling method and flat top sampling method, and that two sampling methods are called as a practical sampling method. So in instantaneous sampling, we are using the principle as a multiplication, and the pulses have a no width. So that means pulses have a width of a zero width, whereas in natural sampling method, so in natural sampling method, in addition to the multiplication, we also use a chopping, and the pulses also have a some width, which is represented by the tau. So by multiplying the baseband signal and impulse of a train, we will get the output g of t. So g of t can be written as x of t is equal to c of t. So that is about the instantaneous sampling and natural sampling. Thanks for watching.